would rather fund the systemic criminalization of people of color than to invest in our future. And now, as the politicians continue to disinvest, corporate America has launched an offensive to capitalize on its instability. The Accreditation Commission, along with the interim administration, are abusing the accreditation process to downsize CCSF and make drastic cuts to courses and programs that are disproportionately affecting low-income communities of color. Despite her egregious agenda to destroy equity, Interim Chancellor has the audacity to call the students who have taken the initiative to save our colleges irresponsible, claiming our efforts are only brought negative attention to City College. No. What's irresponsible is a reckless decision to lay off all part-time counselors, leaving students in the dark during the registration process. What's irresponsible is cutting funding for disabled students' programs and services in the name of long-term stability. What's irresponsible is divesting from the EOPS Second Chance program, which provides formerly incarcerated persons the necessary resources to become a successful student. Such lack of compassion has been detrimental to the livelihood of students, to faculty and staff, but our spirit is not broken. So now we find ourselves at the steps of City Hall, not to ask, but a demand that the city elected officials take immediate action to meet our demands. If there is one lesson we can take from American history that is applicable today, is that real social change is achieved through mass movement. Therefore, we must trust and confide in ourselves. We must continue to organize and build an independent movement based on labor unions, community organizations, community members, and all allies of the oppressed. Only then can we truly fight for the interests of all students, faculty, staff, and marginalized communities who have been singled out and targeted by the relentless cuts. Only then can we achieve true democracy. We are here to make a bold declaration that the educational process must cherish equality, justice, compassion, and a global community. To declare that the aim of education is to find solutions for poverty, for injustice, for violence and war, to strive towards a free, accessible, and quality education for all. We must build an unprecedented resistance in defense of the gains won in past struggles, and if we do so, we will win. For our cause is just. And we have nothing to lose but our chains. Thank you.
Estamos aquí defendiendo nuestras clases. Porque no es justo. Porque debe ser la educación gratis. Gracias a todos por estar aquí. Gracias por este esfuerzo. Gracias porque todos juntos sí se puede. Queremos mantener nuestro colegio para esta generación y para nuevas generaciones. ¡Sí se puede!
And keep this college moving. The voters have spoken. And now, there's a bill going through in Sacramento that's going to trigger money for institutions like City College, where the enrollment has gone down for a variety of reasons. So there is no excuse whatsoever to get into an austerity type of program that the former rapper was just saying. So the Labor Council stands behind this institution, and we are going to continue to make sure that this institution stays the great jewel as it is in San Francisco. Thank you.
To San Francisco, City College embodies the values of equity and inclusion. City College offers people a real chance to learn, to improve their lives, better themselves and their families. Whether you're a recent immigrant, a high school student, a student looking towards a four-year degree, or a student learning vocational skills, City College is a home for you.
Los maestros correr de una orilla a la otra.
All right.
Okay. Así que necesitamos de decirle a la ciudad que hagan lo que tienen que hacer. The city needs to do what it has to do. You know, I've been part with my own brother to vote to support Proposition A. So they would be paying more taxes. They told me, I am paying more taxes because of you. And now they are telling me that there is no money for the classes. Come on. They need to use the money for what we made it for. Okay? So thank you very much. Gracias.
Give it up again for Carlos. This is my fellow student leader right here. We're working hard to fight for our school against all the adversity. Really quick.
So money short now, and so is patience. Who in their right mind cuts education? Go send a message to our legislators. This school belongs to you and me. This city college, like many others, it taught our fathers, it taught our mothers. We've got to fight back. It's our community. This story belongs to you and me.
He did not want to see any of the city colleges closed. We have been here too long, fought too long for education for our youth, especially in the Bayview Hunters Point area. We have the highest rate of non-educated in Bayview Hunters Point. We cannot any longer see that this continue by the city and county of San Francisco. So we must demand, not ask, because we the taxpayers, we just voted to make sure that the college would be fully funded. So keep pushing. Don't stop. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Next, we have an amazing performance. Can win in the labor chorus. Yeah.
It is important that we understand that what this school is facing, what the city is facing, what the country is facing, what the state is facing, is a priorities crisis, not a budget crisis. Right? California is number one in prison spending, but number 49 in education. Do you guys think that's acceptable?
No!
And Prop A is here now. But in the face of Prop A money coming in, we've laid off 18 academic counselors who provide guidance for our students to make healthy educational decisions. We have over 400 students who are on the wait list for EOPS program, which is a program for low-income at-risk students. We have over 180 students who are part of the Second Chance program, a program for ex-offenders who are on the wait list. These students are being denied access. And I say that is wrong. And I say that's why we're here today, and to say enough is enough. We want our city college back, and we want city college to reflect the values that we all have fought so dearly and sweated so much for.
I try to tell them that the world is large, but to him the world is women, liquor stores, and cars. I try to hold him like a baby boy, but now the baby boys, they got guns for toys. And so I hold him like a ticking bomb, and I pray for peace, and I pray for calm, trying to teach him. You have a heart, and you have a mind. And conscious revolution, it could change the tide. Conscious revolution, it could change the tide. And now I see you growing, I see you growing, I see you filling your mind. And you say,
first time in a long time, see you feeling like a champion. See you growing, and you say to me, life never been a broke down love, but it broke me off so good.
$800 million. Is that right? It's a shame. Our administration, they cut out of our mission statement at City College of San Francisco. They cut out lifelong learning. Boo! They cut out cultural enrichment. They are proposing to consolidate all of our retention centers. Consolidation. They're going to consolidate a two-lane center. that serves Filipino students, the African American Scholastic Program, the Asian Pacific American Program, the Latin American Services Network. They want to consolidate it all together, and what's going to happen when they do that? We're going to lose ethnic studies classes. We're going to lose our diversity courses. Boo! It is a shame! And we have to get the information out to our community about what's really happening. Also, our administration has done what? They have cut all of our part-time counselors, all of them. They cut them all. And what they're going to do? They're going to lay off all of our deans. Lay them all off. It is a shame. They are saying that the histories of our communities don't matter. They're saying people like me, people like you, don't deserve to go to rise ahead, to move up in your life. They are disrespecting us and disrespecting our community that we have to fight for. So I'm saying to you guys today, think about the people in this audience. Think about your brothers, your sisters, your family, your friends, all the folks who need this school to get ahead in their life. Think about me. I went from being in the system to now having the opportunity to transfer to one of the best universities in the nation. That is City College. We are City College. I love you. Thank you.
1% by putting an oil severance tax on Chevron, which is located in Richmond, California. In order to win, we need to build a mass movement that allies itself with everyone standing against privatization. A mass movement that's grassroots, where everyone gets a say in what direction we must go. We have the unfinished business of the civil rights and feminist movements of the 60s. Capitalism can't fulfill our needs. We must fight for socialism in order to have free, affordable, quality education for all. To learn more about radicalism, come talk to me and look us up. No cuts, no fees. Education must be free. No cuts, no fees. Education must be free. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And always in struggle for $1. I am the poverty scholar, rocking this attire because me and Mama D did jail time for poverty crimes, just trying to survive in this holler. I'm all the people you don't want to be, never want to see, and look away from, but I'm in your city. I am the poverty scholar, daughter of the strong black Indian mama, for without whom there would be no me. Ashe, mama. I am a welfare queen and a soltera mama of Tiburcio. First of all, I want to give it up to the lonely ancestors upon whose land we're standing on. Can I get a yeah? This is indigenous land upon which we as poor peoples and peoples of color have the right to be educated. Have the right to control our own resources. But a long time ago, that was taken away by some colonizers wearing strange wigs and funny suits. Well, guess what? Those same colonizers are rocking a different program now. Now they're called the Accreditation Board. And all these other fake-ass names are really what they are. Is the new colonizers trying to take our resources from us. So I got mamas in the audience, poor mamas like me, who would not have made it without City College.
Me as sheriff do not call attention to how the city is standing by and letting one of the greatest civic educational institutions go down the tube. Now, our institution of the San Francisco City and County Jail System is completely interfaced with City College. It would be unconscionable for me to stay in City Hall, let a rally like this happen, and for us not to raise our voice in solidarity with all of you. We know that in a city like San Francisco, not only are we very cost prohibitive, we are one of the most wealthiest cities in the United States. It calls into question why there is not the full court press. Just like when I was a supervisor, when we rallied to the defense of the Unified School District, who has a population less than those from San Francisco and around the area that attend City College now. And what's important to us is that our goodwill, compassion, and innovation be extended to saving and sustaining and growing public education, both in the primary and secondary level. But what's critical here and why I'm here is that City College is the great equalizer for those who can afford college and the high supermajority who cannot. And if they cannot get access to education beyond their GED or high school diploma, then I fear they come into my jails. I fear that the 50,000 people that come into contact with the San Francisco jail and sheriff's department system are not going to be given the opportunities to then rebound when they get out of jail. And then I fear by us letting City College fall by the wayside, that only affirms exactly what's happening in San Francisco, that our commitment to class diversity has been completely breached, and we must draw lines to make sure that that does not happen anymore. Thank you.
No to union busting.
No to union busting. We shall not move. No to union busting. We shall not move. Just like a tree that's standing by the water. We shall not be moved.
No to cuts and layoffs.
No to cuts and layoffs, we shall not be moved. No to cuts and layoffs, we shall not be moved.